Hey YouTube, Ant here again from Ant's Guitar Lessons. We're going to cover a James Arthur track today. It's a little bit of an old one, but it's got a lot of basic chords in and it's a pretty standard one to get through. Little bit of finger picking in there, as well as I'll show you some simple strumming patterns if you want to just sing along and play the song, which is really cool. I'm not a massive James Arthur fan, to be honest. I think he sings like he's just woken up drunk. But this one's pretty cool. I do like this song. So let's get zoomed in and I'll show you how it goes. So guitar in standard tuning, capo on the second fret. So everything we're gonna talk about is gonna be relative to the capo, as if it was the nut. Okay, so we have a G chord first. So the chord sequence is a G, and we need our middle finger on the top string in the third fret, pointer finger, fifth string, or the second string down with our pointer finger, our ring finger on the second string from the bottom in the second fret, and our little finger on the thinnest string at the bottom. And we need to, if you remember, we need to get them all up as close as we can to behind the fret bar. And that's our G major. And then we need a D. So our middle finger is on the thinnest string, second fret. Our ring finger is on the second string, third fret, and the pointer finger on the third string, get my words out, third string, second fret, and we strum from this string here, the D string. And then we need an E minor. So we just need our ring finger and our middle finger on the fourth and fifth strings in the second fret, and we're gonna strum all the strings. And a C chord. So, ring finger, fifth string, third fret, middle finger on the fourth string, second fret, and our pointer finger in the first fret on the second string up. And we strum from here, we just missed that low E off. And that's it, that's all the chords. And it has one strumming pattern. So, and it goes G, D, E minor, C. Okay, so the simplest strumming pattern for this song is just four down strums, and that's four strums per chord, and that would make each bar of the song. There's only one chord per bar, and each line of the song is also with each bar and each chord, so it makes it relatively easy to sing along to. Not that I'm going to embarrass myself singing. So we've got the G, D, an E minor, and a C, and back to G, D, E minor, C, G, and the verse and the chords are the verse and the chorus are exactly the same chords in exactly the same sequence with exactly the same strumming pattern. So it's a nice easy one to get through, really good one for beginners. If you just put the song on and you want to play along to it, that will get you through just fine. Okay, if you're feeling a bit more adventurous, we can add a couple of up strums in there and a little bit of technique to make it go along with the pulse of the song and fit the melody a little bit more. So we start with a down, and we're just going to try and hit the lower end of the strings. So down, down, up, up, down, up, down. Just try and catch the bass strings. Down, down, up, down, up. Then the D, down, down, up, down, up. E minor. Thank you. again, that will get you through the whole song with the same sequence. There is a really nice live version where he sings it backstage, and there is a guy playing and strumming along to it, not finger picking it, and he plays something very similar, but he just integrates a few hammer-ons. And he just tries to mix it up a little bit and give it a little bit more flavour. So once you're feeling more comfortable, by all means, you know, have an experiment and see what you can get. Right, I'm going to zoom right in. I'm going to show you the finger picking pattern for how it sounds on the record. Okay, so we're going to start with a G chord. But we don't actually need our little finger or our pointer finger. So we can take those off. They are part of the chord, but they're not going to be involved in the strumming pattern. So the first thing we need to do is strum the bass note with our thumb. Pick the bass note. And then we're going to pick strings 2 and 3 together with our ring finger and with our middle finger and our pointer finger. And then we're going to lift off our ring finger and pick those two strings again. Okay, I'm going to go through that again. Thumb, 2 and 3, take the ring finger off, 2 and 3. So the thicker string, 2 and 3 with the with the ring finger on. And then we're going to pick the bass string again. And we're going to pick string 3 and the bass string. Okay, so we'll run through all of that together. Okay, and then we're going to swap to the D chord. Now again, we don't need all the fingers down, so we can lift our middle finger off, but we do need to wrap our thumb around the top of the second fret to hold down this thicker string on the second fret to create what would effectively be an F sharp, to create an F sharp over D. And we're going to pick again, exactly the same, the thicker string with our thumb. And then using our middle finger and our first finger, I'm going to pick strings 2 and 3. And then we're just going to lift off our ring finger again and pick strings 2 and 3. And then thicker string with our thumb. And the third string, and our thumb again on the thicker string. Okay. Thumb, strings 2 and 3, ring finger off, 2 and 3, thumb, third string, thumb. And then we have the E minor chord. It's exactly the same pattern, but we don't need our thumb on. So we're going to pick an E. So we're going to hit this bass note, this thicker string open. And because it's an E minor, none of the main parts of the chord are involved. We actually would technically be doing an E minor over an E minor 7 here, because we still need to keep our ring finger in the third fret on the second string. So it's the lowest string with our thumb. Strings 2 and 3 together, and again lift off, so you've got no fingers on at all, and then thumb, third string, thumb. Okay, so all those initial chords follow the same pattern. Change a little bit now when we get to the C. So we're going to put the full C shape down, and we're going to pick not the low E string, not the thicker string at the top, but the one below it, the fifth string with our thumb. And then we're going to pick strings 2 and 3, and then we're going to pick all of them together. So that's the three strings we just did, but we're going to pinch them here. So we've got our fifth string and strings 2 and 3. Then just the thumb again, the second string,
and we need to pull off as we do that. And then we're going to strum the third string. We're just going to pick that. Let's run through that again. So we've got the C shape down. We're going to pick with our thumb the fifth string. Then we're going to pick strings two and three. Then we're going to pick the thumb and two and three together. Then the second string. And we're going to pull off with our pointer finger. So just literally pulling your finger off. And then we're going to strum, we're going to pick the third string. And then we're back to the G. And it just loops around and around and around, and that's pretty much it. Okay, thanks for watching. I hope that made sense to you. If not, by all means, leave me a comment. I'll go back and focus on an area for you if you're struggling. It'd be really cool if you posted some videos of yourself playing that song and learning it. That'd be really cool. You could put them on my Facebook page. If you could give me a thumbs up down below and a subscribe, I'll keep the videos coming and we'll all end up playing guitar. All right, thanks very much.